We've said that the cerebrum has gray matter on the outside and white matter on the inside, and that is true generally, but we're going to go ahead and take a look at a cross-section of a brain now, and we're going to see a couple of exceptions to that. So if we take a look at this cross-section of a brain, what you'll notice is, yes, we can see that layer of gray matter along the outside, that's where cell bodies are located. We can see the white matter, this would be a lot of axonal material, and then we can also see these bands inside of the brain, and that's what we're going to focus in on for this slide. These are called the basal nuclei, and these are actually collections of gray matter that exist internally inside of the brain. So what these help to do is coordinate motor movement. And we've been talking about that on the frontal lobe, the precentral gyrus. That's the gyrus that is heavily involved in motor control, being able to move our skeletal muscles, make conscious decisions about what to move. It turns out there has to be a lot of coordination between that precentral gyrus and other centers of the brain in order to get that movement to actually happen. So let's take a look. We're going to learn about what's called a motor circuit. And this is a circuit, just kind of like in physics, circuits are sort of links between electrical pathways. Same thing here in the brain. Let's take a look at this motor circuit. So what happens in this motor circuit is a conscious decision is first made in the frontal lobe. So you decide maybe that you want to move a specific body part. Maybe you want to move your arm, your right arm specifically. So that conscious decision gets made. And when that decision is made, a signal gets sent to one of these basal nuclei, specifically the one called the putamen. It's labeled right here. The putamen is one of these bands right here that you can see. So an excitatory signal gets sent to the putamen. And what's our major excitatory neurotransmitter? If you think back, that was glutamate. Okay, so the neurons that project axons from the frontal cortex down to the putamen, what they're gonna do is release glutamate there at the putamen. Once the putamen is excited, then what it's going to do is release an inhibitory neurotransmitter. And what's the major inhibitory neurotransmitter? GABA. Okay, so this word right here, GABA. GABA gets released by the putamen, and specifically it's being released at these other basal nuclei. Okay, so there's an inhibitory signal shown in red. Inhibitory signal gets sent out to other regions of the brain, and also down to this region of the brain, which we haven't described in detail yet, but it is relevant right here. So let's go ahead and mention this structure right here. This is a region called the substantia nigra. And what happens in the substantia nigra is basically that some things are going to get inhibited and other things are going to get excited. Specifically, what happens in the substantia nigra is there's an inhibitory signal that's sent back up to the thalamus, which is kind of in this region. And the thalamus, remember, the thalamus is really key at coordinating things. So the thalamus then ultimately ends up exciting only very specific regions back on the motor cortex, on the surface of the brain. And so the thalamus excites specific regions, and meanwhile, other regions are being inhibited. There are inhibitory signals being sent through this region of the brain as well. So this is really complex, but the overall takeaway is the end result of all of this is that the intended movements occur. So if you were trying to move your right arm, you move your right arm and you don't also move your like whole entire shoulder and left arm too. So there are movements that are inhibited and that allows just the intended movement to occur. So that's a lot of what the basal nuclei help to coordinate is just coordinating movements. In cases of, for example, Parkinson's disease, what happens is there's degeneration. The neurons in the substantia nigra do not work as well. They do not send their signals. Their inhibitory signals don't make it through as well. And so there's less inhibition of movements. So consequently, one of the main symptoms of Parkinson's is that characteristic shaking. The intended movement happens. The person might be able to move their arm, move their hand, but there's a lot of extra shaking going on as well because other movements are not being inhibited.